Thank you very much indeed. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, distinguished hosts, dear colleagues. I'm very happy to be in Lithuania again. This conference is, among others, about cooperation, and our experience in Eden has been that the professional community is playing a very important role when we arrive to the efficiency and success and impact of the efforts initiated either by the national government or the European Commission or the local institutions themselves. I would like to emphasize the power of the professional community, which in this region, in particular, according to our, perhaps I can say, long experience, Eden will be 25 years old next year. We are celebrating its anniversary in June 2016 at our annual conference. This is something which in the rapidly changing environment, the technology, the demands of the society, of the institutions, has been playing an important role. And of course, it is very impressive how the Baltic countries are able to highlight these cooperative efforts, how with the Scandinavian professional community these efforts did build up a synergy and fertilized each other. And actually, if we have a look around Europe, then we can say that the professional culture of open distance e-learning, ICT enhanced learning, has been perhaps the highest here in the North for different reasons, which would diverse of a different different presentation. If I may, I would like to add just two words to the introduction of my president to the role of Eden. I would like to encourage all of you to have benefits of that what we are doing. This is an association which is the largest in Europe. The access is very easy if, let's say, you belong in one way to another to the Lithuanian Distance Learning Association, then you can for free become a member of the Eden network of academics and professionals, which is the individual section, and thus to enjoy all the individual membership services, which are several. And you know what? We are always strongly considering in my Eden team, and this is a mantra of mine, if you wish, how can we be useful? How can we be useful for the institutions who are our members? How can we be really useful to the people, to the individual? If you wish to send us an email and ask even a simple question or look for partners, this is what such a big organization is for. I'm a kind of pragmatic person, and this is how I have built up my presentation as well. There are so many beautiful things in this open distance e-learning activities and movements with all the complexity which Dennis from the Commission has described. I think even in the world of education, in all sectors, we are working with those people who are open, ambitious, and smart enough to initiate developments, to appreciate and promote innovation. So I think this is a distinguished company. Which were the factors in the last couple of years influencing e-learning? There was a long period when the technology was more important, or seemed to be more important, and was a kind of driver of different changes. Definitely, no, the human and social elements are in the forefront. This is also because the tools, all we know, are becoming cheaper and cheaper, have a higher performance, the access to the internet and networking is very easy, cheap, or often even free. In the meantime, in the socio-economic sphere, I hate the word challenges, but there are challenges, and I wouldn't say that there are so big transformation already in progress. But there is a performance pressure at the universities because of the shortage of national budget, all the economic complications. And what I think is really important that there is a strong competition for the social space, which the different educational institutions, but in particular the universities, are occupying. The knowledge construction is moving away from the traditional educational institutions. Another thing which is really determining what is happening in this field is the change of the user habits and expectations, the increase of the number of users with all the scalability implications. And these users are not only are more and more, but they are also very rapidly learning. So all the new apps which are produced often and intensively. In these economically difficult times, certainly more and more situations are dominated by the market realities, even in the world of education, where some balancing role earlier by the state could be better observed. I think it's a well-known figure, but I couldn't resist to put it here, that the labor productivity was increasing by 85%, while the wages only 35%. So there is in this respect as well an imbalanced situation. Education has in the meantime a social role, in particular the higher education, which is keeping students in frames of the educational system, rather than leaving them to be somewhere on the job market, which is rather uncertain and often unpredictable. This is accompanied by the fact that the postmodern world, Professor Baumann, is putting a premium on the tertiary learning, and I think we know that there are problems with the efficiency and functioning of these institutions. This is topped by the fact that in this information society, with all the accelerated developments, only the well-educated people are really effectively being involved in this new information society. A few words about the distinctive European elements of distance and e-learning. I go through quickly on this, but I think this is important. I mean, something quite different is understood in the United States when we are speaking about distance education or alike, and in Europe. So the social components are much stronger considered, like social exclusion, access, digital gap. The importance of pedagogy in Europe is much higher. This line here in red, this is more or less 15 years old. The critical and responsible use and application of technology. This is from a European Commission document, and I think that it did not lose its importance, however, it is not as often quoted as I think it could be and should be. We all know that there is a linguistic and cultural diversity, which is beautiful in Europe, but often from organizational but also from business point of view, it makes it difficult to make the development efforts business-wise and implementation-wise feasible. Dennis very well described the role of the European Commission in this process. Actually, the national initiatives, as we see them, are not so efficient. So the role which the European Commission with their initiatives, programs, commitments play is very important, and it is one of the main driving forces, not to mention the funding, which is very difficult country by country, and is never enough, of course. And the keywords here are quality, effectiveness, access, and open systems. And this is a not exhaustive list of keywords for education, which in the last couple of years became quite pragmatic again. Growth, employability, accountability, entrepreneurship, very important, innovation everywhere. The development of skills and competencies, adaptability, flexibility. So evidently, the world of education, including open distance, ICT, enhanced learning, is expected to be adapted strongly to the economic environment. I just silently note that in the pedagogy did not change too much. There are efforts, of course, and there are beautiful books about digital pedagogy. This means for me as well, if I may convey a message, that the professional instructional design is extremely important. And if you start the development, then don't forget about that. Critics, problems, I skip this slide. But I like very much this metaphor with rhizomatic learning. I used to be a biologist, and you know, these small roots, I wonder if you knew that the mushrooms are in the world the biggest living organisms, the biggest living organism. Because if you see a small mushroom like like these, which are, I think, especially in your country, many and beautiful and tasty, then this is just, you know, a small outgrowth of this root system in the soil, under the soil, which can be a smaller hill or mountain, you know. This is very similar to the proliferating learning contexts, and that the different learning solutions on the internet are emerging and growing up spontaneously without coordination. The nodes can grow independently without centers. But I would like to, which is also outlined here, that it is a strength and a weakness at the same time, that the content and the competence is legitimated by the network cooperation. This is a very interesting situation. And one last remark which I find important, and what I think that has a distortive effect on the world of learning as well. So, and this is beautiful, and this is congenial. I don't think it was designed, but as it has developed, as it did, that we have the internet, we have the web, and this is filled up by voluntary work for free with information. There are more important informations, less important, more relevant, less relevant. All we know is, you know, user-generated content, Wikipedia, anything. And the tools which I was praising for a few minutes ago, you know, really, and we know the slogans, anytime, anywhere. Yes, but this also means that parts of the burden of education is put on the learner's shoulders. You know, you can learn anytime, anywhere. Please learn on the train when you are traveling to your working place. And I wouldn't like really to invest, you know, to a normal training face-to-face somewhere, part of your working time, you know, but you have your smartphone, you have your tablet, please learn at home. Okay, I don't want to be cynical or destructive, but I think this is really a movement, and this is a movement of resources, this is a redistribution of resources, and what is the most interesting, that it works. I mean, that there are no manifestations and revolutions against this. However, the people are put under this pressure. This is became a requirement, and this is a reorganization of their life and the reorganization of the resources. I would like to draw your attention on this. I am approaching with critics this phenomenon, and all in all, with all the open educational forms, a real breakthrough can be expected when the employers will consider and accept these atypical certifications like MOOCs, you know, as the normal ones. They are reluctant. They are mostly reluctant. There are differences across continents mostly and countries, but this is not happening. So the surveys show that they have reservations with the knowledge and, papers, diplomas, certificates reached in this way. And finally, again, about cooperation, I think that the strength of this community, you and the EDEN community and the teachers, is the civil society and professional communities' coherence, which we can highlight. I am not encouraging any revolution, but I just say that this is something without which no policy, will be approved on national or on international level. We have to find our common understanding, sometimes also common voice. This is in Europe not very well organized. We need to invest in the power of the organizations for the which such a conference organized by a national association is probably the best example. Thank you very much indeed, and again, Eden would like to be useful for you, and please don't hesitate to contact us. I am not offering business, I am offering cooperation. Thank you.